Hello everyone, Tariq here, and welcome back to Super Mario World, Super Mario Advance 2, part 9 apparently. We stopped at Forest Fortress. This time I'm going to try to pronounce it fast. Forest Fortress, Forest Fortress, Forest Fortress. Alright, it's easier than I thought. Alright, this is the third fortress course in this game. And like the first one, it is secret. Why am I saying third? It's the second one. Second fortress. And like the first one, it is on a secret pathway, so I'm not forced to... That was a very mean trick, placing a dragon coin there. I need to start this course over. I'm not going to kill myself. I want to keep my no death run. Alright, there's one problem though. Hopefully... Yeah, I'm not going to try to die here, but... I kinda hope I am going to, because... One little thing I need to talk about now. If you miss... Come on. If you miss a dragon coin in a fortress or castle level... Come on! Luigi, your spin jump is annoying! If you miss a dragon coin in a fortress or... Yeah, now it's definitely over. Midway point. Fortresses and castles crumble, as you may know, if you finish them. The crumbling means you cannot enter them again. In the original game, there's still a trick around that. You can press L and R on the overworld in order to still access them. There's a little bit of a cheat for that. In this version of the game, that is actually non-existent. In order to replay a castle or fortress, simply because you want to or because of not having collected the dragon coins yet, you're going to have to wait until you have cleared the game. Completing the game will open up every course again, including the fortresses and castles. This auto-scroll in the beginning, and therefore giving you the ability to miss a dragon coin, which happened, is going to make sure I am not able to 100% clear the game before I beat the final boss. I would just kill myself, but I have not died yet, and I really like to try to keep this no death run. I'm not going to give it up for something that stupid. Secret here, by the way, if you are at the end of this course, you can fly over to get a lot of one-ups. And yeah, this actually makes sure I am able to force to go back after the final boss. Really annoying. But not the end of the world, because I was planning to do a bonus episode to show off some extra things. Anyway, well, this is apparently going to be one of them. The full 100% completion is going to happen in the bonus episode, sorry. It's annoying enough that they force you to collect all the dragon coins in order to do 100% clear. But to make it even more annoying, you cannot re-enter fortresses or castles if you... clear them before you finish the game. It crumbles now, as you can see. And I can go back and press A all I want, or L and R all I want. Doesn't do anything. You cannot enter the course again. Well, I'm forced to continue. Sorry, 100% before the final boss. Scratch that, not happening. But we are playing Star World 4. Which is, if you are going for shortcuts towards the final boss, the final course you're going to have to play, because this completing this course, or finding a secret exit of course, because as you may know, in the Star Worlds, finding the secret exit will give you progress. So finding the secret exit in this course will take you towards... Come on... I jumped over these paratroopers, I'm pretty sure I did. They are higher than I thought they were. But I got my revenge. Anyway, like I said, if you clear this course, the secret exit of this course, it'll take you to the fifth entrance of the Star Road. And as you may have seen already in World 2, when we got our first glimpse of the final world in this game. That is where Star Road 5 takes you, directly towards the final boss. Right, there's actually some blocks down here. That is secret exit stuff. But I'm of course going to go normal exit first, because that also needs to be cleared. Same deal as with the Forest of Illusion Ghost House and Forest of Illusion 1. Even though these pathways are already visible on the overworld, the pathway this normal exit gives you is still required to do if you want 100% when it comes to clear rate in exits. And I missed the dragon coin again. I need to go back again. I think I know which one I missed. It's somewhere up here, I think. Yeah, there it is. Funny how when you go through the course and you don't realize that there is one, and this, the moment you see the goal and you're like, I missed one, you immediately know which one it is. You would think that I actually remember the first time I passed there, because apparently it is in my memory. The moment I saw the goal, I know it was that one. At least I was pretty sure it was that one. I was not 100% sure. Oh, she got Yoshi, the hitbox is so weird with this. I sometimes just simply jump through it. Really weird. Come on. Dang it, there goes my 100%. I did almost get it. Oh, it's a pretty nice shape, actually. I don't want you. I don't want you. I don't want you. Now I want you. I always try to get them at the same time. If that wasn't obvious. Alright. Now for the real deal. Because clearing this was just for getting the exit. Overworld-wise, it gave us nothing. Nothing that we did not already have, so this time, serious stuff. Secret exit time. I've already showed where it was with the blocks. You might think that the Switch Palaces are required to get there. Actually not true, there are still ways to cheese your way in there. But I've already got Switch Palaces, so you see green here and red here. But there's still ways around that you can just simply fly your way up here or float downward from the platform on the right. There's still ways to get here. But this is where they hit this course, the secret exit. Which will take us to the final entry point of Star Road. Which will take us right towards the final boss. Bowser's Castle is where this connects to. And unlike other Star Roads, you don't actually have to clear the course connected to it in order to activate the pathway, as you can see. It is already here. And there is a reason for that. And I'm not explaining that right now. I'm going to explain that when I actually start doing the course. Because, like always, I'm not going to do that until I meet... I can't play that course anymore. Until I meet the Star Road on the overworld regularly. We have cleared everything here, except for that dragon coin and fortress, not talking about that. And looking at that, this is the only course with another secret exit we have not done yet. And guess what? Progress. In order to continue on the overworld, get to castle number 5, that is. This is actually the course where you need to do that. It's a simple matter of finding the secret exit here. And it might surprise you that I know where that is. As if I have never played this game before. This large pipe, all the way at the end, as you can see, here's the goal. Is actually a pipe you can enter. You do need to be at least Big Mario in order to finish this, because you need to get rid of these blocks. And of course, get the key through the wall, because why not? Why would you do it the normal way? And this will take us out of the forest and towards Roy's Castle. This is actually a course I really love playing around on. I'm not going to do it because I'd like to keep my no-death run. The playing around I'm talking about is asking for death. I'm not going to do that. Yet. I think I'm going to show that off in the bonus content, actually. You can actually play around with the reserve item here. Because you're so close to the top of the screen, if you place yourself in a good position where you're directly under your reserve item, keep spamming the select button, you can play around. Yeah, I did not say I'm not going to play around at all in this course. Snake blocks are a thing. If you think Super Mario Maker was the one to introduce that, you were surely mistaken. This is the game where they came from. And this is actually one of two courses... This is actually one of two courses in this game that that uses them. Luckily, there are fast ones. The ones they give you in Mario Maker, the slow speed ones, those are really annoying. Move way too slow. Even though I actually also used one in one of my levels. In a tight spot, I actually used one of these slow-moving coin snakes, or block snakes. Do remember to get off here, because it goes into the abyss there. I hit the speed switch here, because a 1-up will fall. Come on! No 1-up for me. I jumped over you. Still got my cape, but I did lose my reserve item. Alright, Roy. First repeat boss, by the way. This is actually the same way Morton's fight worked, with one exception. I'll show it off here. As you can see, the walls will start moving towards each other. So this is actually a quote-unquote timed boss battle, where if you're too slow, the walls will crush you, or simply make it harder for you because of having less room. Yeah, there are only four boss fights in this game, because starting from this point, we actually start to see variations of boss fights we've already seen. In this case, a variation of the Morton boss fight. And the bomb apparently doesn't work. Oh, it does work. Mario and Luigi have found their way through the Forest of Illusion and have put an end to Roy Koopa in Castle Number 5. Onward to the deliciously dangerous Chocolate Island. Mario, you look amazing. Mario blowing himself up. Not something you see every day in your common Mario game. Pretty funny how they played around with that. Right, Chocolate Island number 1. We are entering World 6 finally. After World 5 being kind of a maze. Not really. We get introduced to a new enemy. These guys are either big or small. They are rhinoceros-like dinosaurs by the appropriate name of Dino Rhinos. And the small ones are called Dino Tops, I believe. And as you can see, you can actually jump them regularly. Doesn't work with Yoshi, but if you jump on them regularly, if they are big, they become these little guys. And the little guys actually sometimes breathe fire, so be careful for that a little bit. And I'm not saying a little bit for nothing, because they are, in all honesty, not really that big of a threat. So, right, go in here to get shot from the pipe right next to us. Whee! Gotta have our fun sometimes. Getting shot from pipes is definitely fun. It's also something I played around with when I made my ROM hack for this game. Actually made one course, a pipe maze I think it was. It's actually a course where I finished off with one of these pipes where you get shot right at the goal. I place it right beside the goal and you actually get shot into the goal. Pretty funny actually. I knew there was a secret pipe here. I know my Super Mario World. I've played this game at least twice. Try more like 1,000 times. Okay, I did not touch the water. Where's my prize? Whee! Bam. Let's get back, because I'm pretty sure I missed something. This is where you end up. And that guy's trying to jump over. It's not really working too well, it looks like. Alright, let's just finish the course. Not something we are not able to do at this point. Right, the ghost house here. If you look at the world map closely, you can see there's no real places to go with the exception of one direction. indicating that this is once again a ghost house with only one exit. And you would be correct about that, because indeed, there is only one exit here. When we get introduced to these moving gaps in the floor, as you can see. And we get introduced to Fishing Booze, an undead Lakitu, which, comparable to the Lakitu carrying the 1-Up, is trying to follow you in order to touch his quote-unquote 1-Up, which is a flame in this case. So no 1-Up for you if you touch it now. You actually get hurt. So this is kind of course where you can't jump too high, because as you can see, he cannot go lower than the position he is in right now. So you just simply make sure to not jump too high. Midway point, once again, added in this version. It is not present in the original. Original game does not give you midway points in water levels as much as in ghost houses, because once again, ghost houses did not give you midway points. You changed that in this version of the game. Basically, every single course has a midway point in this game. Right, and more new stuff in this course, by the way. These boos, which are blocks, get introduced. Work the same as any normal boo, with the exception that whenever they go into hiding mode, they actually become blocks that you can use. And these boo chains, not too sure how to call them, they probably have an official name, but can also be quite annoying. They bounce around the course, as you can see, have a little bit of a boo tail behind them, which can also hurt you. But the only reason to go here is because of the dragon coin and the 1-Up. You can lure these block boos here in order to reach this door, but you don't have to if you have a cape like me. You can simply fly up here. Once again, the cheese is real. I will promise you to never play a Mario game without cheesing. At least once or twice. Sometimes even more. Alright, and say hello to probably the most complicated course in this entire game. Because Chocolate Island 2 has a vast array of ways of clearing it, I will try to cover them all. First, I will do two ways of clearing this course, because of having to clear them two ways anyway. Secret exit, and you know what I mean. The coins you collect or the time remaining can affect your progress in this area. Can you find the special goal? Well, that I can find, but there's actually, like I was trying to say, a lot of rooms in this. I'll try to show them all off. Not in the first time through, because there are three ways through all of the rooms. I can show off two of them because of clearing the normal course. The second one for clearing the secret course. And the third time through, showing off the third rooms, I'll do in the bonus content. That is something that is bonus content. I'm not going to play this course three times just to show it off in the normal playthrough. Right, collect as many coins as you can. And if you do, you will end up here. This is the first room of room number two. Like I said, there are three variants of room number two. This is the first one. Remember to collect the dragon coins. The dragon coins are present in all of the rooms, I think. I might mistake one or two rooms. We'll see that in the future. But I'm pretty sure you don't have to worry about collecting the dragon coins when it comes to going through these rooms. Alright, when it comes to entering this third room, the time remaining actually affects it. I'll put an annotation on screen in order to make it even more clear. And this room number four is actually determined by the number of dragon coins you have. I have four right now, so I'll get this room. If I had less dragon coins, I would have gone to a different room. And the fourth room is always the final one. That's always the one where the goal is given to you. Right, I'll just use the P-switch to get a reserve item. I think that's the reason they give it to me, so might as well use it for that. This is actually continuation, normal pathway, but of course, you might have seen, it is a red dotted course, and there's a pipe above us. So, we need to do it again. Only this time we need to find that secret exit. And the secret exit is actually hidden in the third room. So we need to book it, because like I said, the third room is actually determined by the time you have remaining. And having at least 250 seconds remaining, or more, will give you the variant of the third room, which actually has the secret exit. I'm making it quite easily. Everything above 250 is enough to get here. And you'll get to this room, which is the second variant of the third room. We also immediately saw the second variant of the second room, because of me not collecting the coins in the first room, gave me a different room there as well. The paratrooper room, I always call that. This is the charge and chuck room, the ones who throw the baseballs. And I'm better at throwing stuff. How did I not get hit there? No, doesn't matter. Anyway, if you survive this room, key, keyhole, done. And of course, there's even more variants of rooms you can go through here. But that will come when I show off everything that has not been shown off. That is bonus content. For now, we are done with this course. And we will continue through this pipeway towards the secret pathway of this course. But I'm seeing we're going to do that next time, because I see 21 minutes already, so the contents of this pipe will be kept a secret for now, as if people don't know this game. Well, there might be a handful of people who never played this game. You might never know. It is possible. So, but that'll be for next time. Thanks for watching, and Treeks out.